Mit is a felvétel, szóljon a forog.
Forog.
Akkor felvétel 3, 2, 1, tessék.
Jó napot kívánok, köszöntöm Önöket. Amióta a négyszeres Európa bajnok Natalia Tarasova, a magyar szinkronisztó válogatott szövetségi kapitánya, azóta hatalmas lendület lett Magyarországon a sportán. Sikerességének, sikerének tudtának, hogy az elmondatok sorban. Szia Natalia!
Hello!
Hogyan kerültél Magyarországra? Miért Magyarországot választottak 3 évvel ezelőtt?
Because for me it was very interesting goal to participate as a coach and coaching Hungary for the World Championship what was in Budapest, and for me it was very interesting work, and I decided to take this job over.
Láttad előtte a lányokat versenyezni vagy edzeni, mielőtt ide jöttél?
I saw a few of them because they were also participating in some international competition, a duet. But the whole team, no, I didn't know which levels are the athletes are here. So for me it was like something interesting and unknown.
Mi volt a tapasztalatod, hogy az első benyomásokkal kapcsolatban, amikor elkezdtétek a
munkát?
It was actually very difficult to start because I was expecting a little bit higher level of the swimmers, but when I realized that they are have some empty spots and the technical elements and everywhere, so I was like a little bit stressed. But after half a year we get along together and we started like to understand each other better, and it was good.
Hogy látod, hogy ez alatt a 3 év alatt, amióta átvette az irányításokat, mennyit fejlődtek, illetve mennyire vagy önök
elégedett?
I think they developed a lot. Everybody like now follow my structure, I would say. And I think even smaller children know the way how they have to work. So for me now it's much easier than before because everybody following the same structure, and I think they developing like the children looking at the older ones. So now we're start the process now.
Oroszországból jöttél, ahol hatalmas hagyománya van ennek a sportágnak, és az élmezőnyben vannak az orosz versenyzők. Miben más az orosz
versenyzők?
We start our sport a little bit earlier, like at 7 years old, and 7 and a half girls are already like half professionals, I would say, because they're training like after at 8 years old, everybody go every day to the training 6 times per week, like 3 to 4 hours, the children. So, and I think until 12 years old, they are training like really strictly every day, 6 times per week. So I think this is the key, and also they have a lot of basic positions, like boring things, and they are doing a lot of boring stuff.
3 kontinensen is dolgoztál már edzőként, jártál már Amerikában is. Mi a különbség?
Yes, everywhere it's very different. In the United States they are very like happy, you know, everything is fun, and this work is like have fun you guys, and everything is like everybody's smiling, so they don't take it as a hard training. In Russia it's everything serious, everybody is like really serious about the work they make. Here we are trying to combine everything, so we are trying to be serious, but of course I would like some time to have fun with the girls, and we are making fun in the training, especially the first half a year, like we are playing some water polo or some nice play games outside, and we are creating some fun routines. So like I try to combine from all my knowledge from different countries, and I try to apply here. Philosophy, I think the hard work pays off, and I think the girls are seeing this now, and when we work very hard, and I think they see that everybody appreciate, for example, the judges with the scores and the crowd with the like applause, you know, so if they're making a really good job, so everybody see this and the girls are enjoying this feeling after. They get medals, now we started to get medals finally, which is very big thing for the Hungary, and I think it's some steps are going forward.
Mivel tudod motiválni a lányokat, mert ugye pont abban az életkorban vannak, amikor szórakoznának, barátokkal találkoznának, ehelyett ugye napi 8 óra edzés van, és nem lehet mellett.
Well, we're not training 6-8 hours. Usually we're training like 4 to 5 hours. Depends on which stage before the competition we are. Usually it's 4. 1 hour in the gym and 3 hours in the water, so which is not a lot, I would say. But I think my girls are very organized, so they know when to do the homework, when to have a party, when to practice hard. So I think they are organized and they can combine all the things together in their life at the moment. But with the teenagers, sometimes it's very difficult, actually. We do a lot of swimming, a lot of we do some acrobatic jumping with the coach. We're doing a lot of, we never come to the side of the pool, for example. The girls are always working on the center of the pool, which is actually hard. We're working with the weights and we're doing our routines with the weights, which is actually very difficult. So, but after they take out the weights, and for them it's like lighter, and I think they are more like stronger in everything. I think it's very hard to, you know, to motivate the girls all the time, but I'm trying, you know, like to be, for example, outside of the pool, I'm trying to be like a normal person, not a coach. So I think maybe this combination can work for us, you know, like to be very strict in the pool and after a little bit softer outside. And I think in the way, so they can feel that I'm like a normal, but strict. I'm actually very happy to hear this because it's very nice words from her, and I think maybe she maybe see some new wave, so maybe she see that like maybe we can move a little bit more forward, or like something new can happen, and I think it's happening now. So I think she was totally right before. So I think we are trying to make everything new, and now our federation is working much better, and everybody is motivated. Everybody like pushing us everywhere, so, and we are working very hard, and we're trying to show that we really want to, we deserve this attention, I would say, because we're trying like really hard, and we're trying to step forward and forward every competition. I'm sorry, can you please repeat the question?
How do you relax? What do you do in your free time? You know that you're away from your family.
Now we came from the competition actually, and we had 3 days off, and I went to Moscow to see my family, to spend time with my son. We went to the movies, we did a lot of fun, we went to the fun park, and of course he missed me so much, but actually he will come because we're traveling, like I'm traveling home, and he will come in 1 week to stay with me for a while, so it's not very easy, but my parents are helping me a lot, so they're trying to manage my life, I would say. Also. We had a, well, it was my personal decision and my family decision that I have to continue with the study. Like I went to university, we had the program I wanted to get a good education, which I got in the United States, my first education. So I'm really happy about this. There I was swimming also, so my career didn't finish like totally, so I was still swimming in America, and in the national championships I was competing, so it was nice for me. Yes, it's a huge difference, and it's very, very difficult to stay outside, which I never could imagine when I was in the water as an athlete, because you cannot help anymore. You're just staying, and doesn't matter what's happening there, you can just stay and like be nervous and shake from inside, but pray for the girls and like that they can do very well, but you cannot help them. In the water, when you are an athlete, you can change everything every second, like something happened, you can change, but outside it's a very nervous atmosphere inside of you, you know. So I'm very nervous all the time for my girls, and I know like every second of the routine, and I can see if something is happening there, like not planned. So I'm like, oh my God, what will happen next? So Yes, I think much harder to stay outside.
Most májusban volt a felnőtt világkupa Budapesten, a 13. álló világkupa sorozat Budapesti állomása. Mennyire vagy elégedett az
eredményen?
Yes, it was a step for us. I think we didn't perform as I would like them to perform some, because I think it was a like competition after competition. Maybe the girls already was tired for the team event, for example. And the team, I would like them to be stronger, but they did very well in Madrid this week. But for the Budapest, I think all the routine, all the other routines was very nice, solo and duet, and most of them were very good. I'm really happy with the progress. Of course, we have to work on some more things, but I was happy at that stage what they did.
Júniusban lesz a junior világbajnokságot. Milyen eredmények számít? Ez milyen elvárásaid? Akár magaddal vagy a lányokkal szemben?
This is, it will be competing the same team, so I'm actually waiting for the really strong results, strong performances, strong results, because these children are very young and they show already very good level at the senior level, you know. So it, I think it will be very strong, like that we're moving forward. Of course, my dream and the girls' dream are is to go to the top 12. We will try this. We don't know how it happened, because in synchronized swimming you cannot like actually predict, like with the places you cannot predict how many, because these judges are giving the scores like today like this, tomorrow like this. So, but I hope that we can really show that we are improving, we are here, and we changed everything. So I really hope to be like in the final, but I cannot say, I cannot promise this, but we will try our best to do everything what is possible. Oh, these feelings were unforgettable, I would say, because it was the whole stance with the people, with the flags, and I still have goosebumps when I'm watching the video from this. It's a lot of people are cheering, and for the girls it's the best, you know, they feel like they are flying. And of course, when the, it was Budapest Open here, 3,000 people came to watch, and it was very, very good atmosphere also for the girls. And of course, everybody enjoying, for them it's like extra power. So if some like more people will come, we are just happy to see more supporters.
Azt hogyan látod, hogy ez miért van, hogy egyre jobban előtérbe kerül a sporták Magyarországon? Tele vannak a lelátók, és egyre jobbak az eredmények.
I think everybody is starting to like, because now we start to swim synchronized, more beautiful, stronger. We're working with the outside professional people, like Anastasia Ermakova was helping us. She's a four-time Olympic champion. A lot of people are involved in the sport. Our clubs are supporting us now much better than before, and I think it's a common work of all Hungarian all the sport in Hungary, synchronized swimming sport, you know, like all the clubs, everybody is supporting us. So I think common work is making this big push up.
Azt nyilatkoztad egyszer, hogy te hiszel abban, hogy a kemény munka meghozza a gyümölcsét, és kockáztatás nélkül nincs siker. Most mit kockáztatsz? Milyen rizikót vállalsz a junior világbajnokságra?
Well, we are all the risk, I think, everybody waiting from us, of course, like every time, okay, now we're practicing so hard, where is the results? Unfortunately, in synchronized swimming, it's not like, you know, okay, this is the results, right?